Welcome again, students. This time we are going to start some new topic of the same chapter, that is computer networking. The topic is communication media. Communication media or the transmission media. Communication media or the transmission media are the same. Now, what is it? A communication media is a transmission media used for sending data or signal across the network between two communicating devices. To send some information from one system to another system in a computer network, communication media is very much needed. From one system to another system, and communication media may be wired or without wire, that is wireless. So in this time we are going to learn several types of wired communication media and several types of wireless communication media. See, first of all, types of communication or transmission media. Communication media or transmission media are the same thing, okay? See, communication media. Communication media is of two types, guided media and unguided media. Guided media means wired media, means physical media is there. And first one is twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable. And in unguided media, that is wireless media, there is radio waves, microwaves, satellite link, and so many other things, Bluetooth, infrared ray, so many things are there. We are going to learn these things one by one. See, guided and unguided media, what are the differences between these two? All communication or transmission media is divided into broadly categories, that is two categories. First is guided media and second one is unguided media. Guided media is also called wired media. Unguided media also called wireless media. See, what is guided media? Guided media is also known as physical or conducted media. These media uses wires for transmitting data. Various wired communication connections are established. So many wired communications are, examples are twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable. See, unguided media. Unguided media means wireless media. A transmission media that does not require the uses of cable for transmission of data is known as unguided media. These transmission media don't use cables or wires or any physical medium. These are wireless. It is a wireless transmission media or non-physical media, as the transmission takes place through various types of electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves means radio waves, satellite links, microwave links, these things. Through these things, these unguided media is working. So there are two types of media, guided and unguided communication media. First of all, we will learn guided media or wired networking technologies. These media uses wires. Twisted pair cable. Twisted means rotated pair. A pair of cable means there are two cables and both cables are twisted with each other. Rotated with each other. See the example here. This is the example of twisted pair cable. Two pair of cable is there, both are twisted with one another. See the example here. Total four pairs of twisted cables. This is used mostly in wired communication media or twisted pair cable. See, a twisted pair cable is the oldest, simplest, and the most common type of conducted media or the physical media. Most common. Every time a networking is to be established, this cable is required. This skewer is commonly used. Now it is made up of two plastic insulated copper wires. There are two copper wires which are twisted together to form a single wire. Okay, to form a single wire, they are twisted with each other, but there are two pair of cables. Each wire is of 1 mm thick. Out of these two wires, only one carries the actual connection. Only one carries the actual signal, while the other is used for ground reference. For grounding purpose, the other cable, other wire is used. The first wire carries the signal. The wires so twisted are helpful in avoiding interferences. Actually, what happened when we are transmitting some signals, some data from one signals from one system to another system through a wired cable, there are so many magnetic interferences which disturbs, which makes the data error. Okay, which distort the data, and the receiving end, the receiving computer, they sometimes get corrupted data, sometimes get invalid data, or data may not reach at the destination. So to avoid these interferences, these magnetic interferences, these wires are twisted. That's why these are twisted. Twisted means rotated. Okay, that's why they are twisted with each other. So and the bleeding, understand, bleeding of signals from wires, from communication media, is known as crosstalk. And this twisting of cable helps in reducing this crosstalk. Okay, now twisted pair can be specified as category 1 to 5. These are the common category 1 to 5. Okay, for other purposes, category 1 to 5 cables are used, but for computer communication, for computer networking, CAT 6 cable, category 6 twisted pair is used, and it is high transmission rate, from 200 Mbps to 400 meters. 200 Mbps, 400 meters, it gives easily. Now there are two pair, twisted pair comes in two varieties. Twisted pair cable comes in two varieties. First is known as shielded twisted pair cable. Shielded twisted pair cable, STP cable, is also known as STP cable. Now STP cables are covered in metal foil. This makes them indifferent to noise and crosstalk. See, this is the picture. Okay, the shielded twisted pair cable and unshielded twisted pair cable are almost same, but here this shield is given. This shield is given in shielded twisted pair cable. Now see what is unshielded twisted pair cable. This is unshielded twisted pair cable. Here here shield is no more. Shield is not given. Only the cable is given. Two pair of cables. Jacket is there, copper wire is there. This is unshielded pair cable. Unshielded has 7 categories, each suitable for a specific use. In computer network, mostly used CAT5, CAT5E and CAT6 cable are used. For computer network, as we have already said, that CAT6 cable is mostly suitable. Also CAT5 cable can also be used. Both are, only shield is difference there. Advantages of twisted pair cable. Advantages. So many advantages are there. First, it is simple to use. It is inexpensive. It costs less and does not require skilled personnel. It is less susceptible to electrical interferences caused by nearby equipments or wires in a telephone system. Less susceptible, because it is twisted, that's why it is twisted. Signals can travel several kilometers without amplification when twisted pair are used. Okay, signals can travel several kilometers without amplification when twisted pair wires are used. See, these media can be used for both analog and digital data transmission, for both purpose. Several megabits per second can be achieved for a few kilometers in many ways. Several megabits 200 okay 500 cat 6 cable can give up to you know there are also cat 7 cable is also there it can give 1 Gbps speed okay so many speed is there so much speed is there now if a portion of a twisted pair cable is damaged the entire network does not shut down sometimes it may twisted pair cable may damaged then entire network does not stop okay does not shut down it may it continued working from other systems okay some disadvantages as some advantages there some disadvantages also there disadvantage twisted pair cable STP wire is physically larger and more expensive than twisted pair wire STP wire okay is physically larger means thicker is there and also more expensive STP cable if we are using STP cable which gives data traveling more bandwidth okay more data can it can carry this is a benefit and longer range can be used STP cable okay but it is more expensive than other unshielded UTP cable now STP is more difficult to connect to a terminating block due to shielding part is there and that's why it is very much difficult to connect a terminating block now it is easily picks up noise signal which results in higher error rates when the length exceeds 100 meters if the length exceeds 100 meters then the signal may not arrive appropriately okay because the interferences encounters and bleeding of signals occurs that is known as crosstalk occurs that's why it is having higher error rate so there is solution also we can use repeater at each interval of 100 meters repeater can be used which amplifies the signal and further it allows to extend more 100 meters okay so next disadvantage is being the thin in size it is likely to break easily okay due to thin in size likely to break it is said about unshielded pair cable now shielded pair cable there is a shield which does not allow to break it easily so STP cable can be used if a larger range is required okay now next one cable is coaxial cable it is another type of communication media under guided media this is known as coaxial cable a coaxial cable is generally called coax wire in short it is called coax wire it consists of insulated copper wire surrounded by a braided metal shield and covered in a plastic jacket coax cables are capable of carrying higher frequency signals than that of twisted pair cables okay higher frequency signals can be carried with the help of coaxial cables that's why these coaxial cables are used in television network mostly used in cable television communication okay now the wrapped structure provides it a good shield against noise and crosstalk okay there you can see here that it is having a seal this wrapping seal okay the another seal two types of seal is given here and one copper wire this carries the signal okay see outside insulation this is the copper mesh this is again the insulation then this is the copper wire which carries the signal only once signal one wire is here which carries the signal and other supports it and reduces the crosstalk or the magnetic interferences and these cables are able to carry longer distances data and mostly used for cable TV connection coaxial cables provide high bandwidth rates up to 450 megabits per second coaxial cables are widely used for internet connections and cable televisions mostly useful coaxial cable also comes in two primary physical types, thin coaxial cable and thick coaxial cable. Okay, now understood, you must remember that a coaxial cable contains made up of like this. This is the outer shield made up of plastic wire mesh. Okay, it is a wire mesh to reduce crosstalk or magnetic interferences. Insulator is there, again insulator is there, and this is the conductor. This is the actual wire, single wire, which carries the signal. Okay, now advantages of coaxial cable. Coaxial cable can support greater cable length between network devices than twisted pair cable. Twisted pair cable cannot be extended more than 100 meters. If we want to extend more than 100 meter, then we should use repeater at the interval of 100 meters. But in coaxial cable, we can use up to 500 meters without any repeater. It is useful for transmitting analog as well as digital data across the network. It is widely used for cable television and internet connection. Coaxial are used for transmitting several channels simultaneously. You can see that in cable televisions, several channels are there. Just tune in the channels, and this whole channel is transmitted with the help of single cable only. Okay, that is, they are helpful for broadband transmission also, because it can transmit several channels at the same time. That's why it is very much useful for broadband transmission. Okay, now coaxial cable has excellent noise immunity. Noise immunity means there is a copper mesh. Okay, there is again an insulation. That's why it reduces so negligible crosstalks and other interferences. Okay, because of thick covering outside and insulated wires. Now, thick coaxial cable has an extra protective plastic cover. Okay, thick coaxial. There are two types of coaxial cable: thin coaxial cable and thick coaxial. Thick coaxial cable is again protective with extra protective plastic cover, which helps again away from moisture and other different types of hazards. Okay, it is relatively inexpensive as compared to fiber optic cable. There is another type of cable, that is fiber optic cable, which is most expensive as compared to that fiber optic cable. This is inexpensive. Coaxial cable is inexpensive. Now, some disadvantage also there. Thick coaxial cable do not bend easily and thus are difficult to install. Sometimes thick do not bend easily. It is also difficult to install. It is expensive as compared to twisted pair cable. If we compare with twisted pair cable, then it is expensive, more expensive is there. Okay. Now next one is fiber optic cable. Okay, see the fiber optic cable. Fiber optic cable is having the one core, one single wire which carries the signal, then cladding. Cladding means the insulation or some type of protective layer is there, and then sheath. Sheath is also a protective layer, okay, which makes this cable very much protected. Okay, see, this is the example. Okay, in a single fiber optic cable, there are so many cables are attached here. Okay, this is the copper mesh, this is insulin, sheath is known as, okay, cladding is there, so many things are there. Okay, we will learn it one by one. Fiber optic transmit light signals. See here, it transmits light signal rather than electrical signals. The previous two, twisted pair cable and coaxial cable, transmits electrical signals, but in fiber optic cable, light signals are transmitted rather than electrical signal. Several glass fibers are bundled together and are encased in an insulated covering. When the light enters the fiber optic,
The light pulse inside the cable hits the outer wall of the wire at a similar angle, which helps in moving the light wave forward. Okay, there is an light pulse. Okay, the light pulse inside the cable hits the outer wall. There is a cladding. Okay, in cladding, it is also a mirror-like thing. Okay, which reflects, which helps to forward the light from one location to another location. It helps to forward the light, that cladding. Okay, the outer surface of the glass wire provides just right the right angle reflection. This cladding provides the provides the right angle reflection. Okay, to keep the light bouncing back and forth along the length of the cable. Light is moving forward, okay, one by one, like this. Okay, like the light source used in this process is light emitting diode. Diodes to produce light emitting diode, LED, is used.
You can see here how fiber optic cables works.
Depending on the design of the core in relationship to the surrounding cladding. Depending on the type of light source used, the light waves propagating through the core may follow a variety of paths. A mode describes the path of a light wave as it travels through the core. The mode or path is determined by the angle of the light wave entering the strand and the refractive index of the cladding. If the angle of the entering light wave is too sharp, the wave will not propagate through the cable. There are single and multi-mode fiber optic strands. Both single mode and multi-mode fibers are typically 125 microns in outside diameter.
Now you understand that the fiber optic cables are two types, single mode and multi-mode. Single mode fiber optic transmits only single light width. And in multi-mode, fiber uses multiple light paths. Okay, whatever example we have seen, that is the example of multi-mode fiber optic cable. Okay, you can see here what is the diameter of each and every part of the fiber optic cable. The core is 8 mu meter diameter, cladding is 125 mu meter. Okay, buffer is having 250 mm and jacket is 400 mm, like this. Okay. Now, advantages of fiber optic cable. So many advantages there. Fiber optic typically offers better bandwidth and carry more information at once. As the signal travels in the form of light, okay, there is less attenuation. Less attenuation means the less interferences, less loss of connection or the data. Okay, and signal degradation. Signal is rarely degraded, and there is no need of repeater at all. Optic fiber wires are made of glass, so there is less risk of fire. Fire may not go out because of absence of spark hazard. Okay, this is the benefit. Now, other advantages is that fiber optic cables are much thinner and lighter than metal wires, and hence easier to install. Okay, it is thinner and metal, and it is easier to install. Install means just laying out the cable is easier. Laying out the cable is easier. Okay, or carrying the cable from one place to another place is easier. It does not leak signals. There is no crosstalk. There is no magnetic interferences because it is made up of glass and light travels through these glasses. So it is immune to eavesdropping. Next is, a signal can run for 50 kilometers without requiring knee regeneration. See here, what are the so much advantages it is having. If a twisted pair cable can go up to 100 meter only. A coaxial cable can go up to 500 or 400 meter only. But in case of fiber optic cable, it can go without any requiring of regeneration up to 50 km. But some disadvantages also there. A highly skilled labor is required for installation and maintenance. Installation means connection, joining computers or joining the cables at some joining points. This requires highly skilled labor or the technician. It is relatively expensive as compared to other guided media. It is expensive also. A fiber optic is made of glass. They can be easily broken. Now other problem is there. It is made of glass. It is immune to interferences. Okay, but it is easily broken. So care is taken. A light travels in a straight line. Two fibers are needed if we need bi-directional communication. Now there is unidirectional. In one direction we can send information. Okay, so to receive some information we need bi-directional communication. Now three types of guided media we have learned: twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, and fiber cable. See the what are the comparison here. Twisted pair cable comes in two types, UTP and STP. Both are having maximum length 100 meters, bandwidth supported 100 Mbps and 500 Mbps. Easy, moderate installation is very much easy for UTP cables and moderate for STP cable. Cost is cheapest, moderate. Interferences is very high, moderate. Okay. Now coaxial cable, it comes also in two types, thin net and thick net. Okay, and the maximum segment length is 185 meters for thin net and 500 meters for thick net. It gives us 10 Mbps bandwidth. Installation is easy for thin net and very difficult for thick net. Now it is cheap and moderate, and interferences is moderate and it is low. In fiber optic cable also comes two mode, single node and multi node. Maximum length 2 kilometers, but for multi node it can come up to 50 to 100 kilometers. It can give you 100 Mbps speed bandwidth, and for multi node it can give you 2 Gbps. And installation is very hard and it is expensive, but interferences is negligible, that is none. Okay. Now next we are going to learn unguided media or wireless networking technologies. A transmission media that does not require use of cables. There is no need of cables for unguided media. See, features of unguided media. Transmitter media, transmission and reception is achieved by means of an antenna. There must be an antenna. To use unguided media, there must be an antenna, receiving antenna and sending antenna. Transmission can be either directional or omnidirectional. Now understand what is directional and omnidirectional. See, directional means transmitting antenna puts out focus beam. Transmitter receiver must be aligned, means both the antenna or both the devices must be in a line of sight, means both must see each other. Okay, then only data can be transferred or transmitted through this directional unguided media. But in unguided media, omnidirectional unguided media, signal spreads out in all direction, though there is no need to be in aligned. Okay, and can receive by many antenna at the same time. Say for example, example is infrared or microwaves uses line of sight direction, but in omnidirection radio waves, this does not require the mobile connection. Uses radio waves, so in that there is no need of line of sight connection. Okay, now next, first one we will learn microwave. Microwave signals are used to transmit data without the use of cables. Because it is wireless, it is a line of sight transmission. Line of sight transmission means both the devices which is sending and receiving, both must be in line of sight, both must be seeing one together, okay, as signal travels in a straight line. In microwave communication, two directional parabolic antennas are mounted on towers, buildings or hills to send and receive signals through air. However, they must be properly aligned with each other, otherwise the signal will not be focused well at the receiving antenna, because both must be in the same length. See the example here. This is parabolic. Parabolic antenna is needed and direct line of sight path is there. Okay. This is the example. Now, advantages of microwave transmission. It is cheaper source of communication, less cost, and is avoids using cables and maintaining repeaters. We don't need any cables or repeaters for maintenance. That's why it is cheaper. Communication through microwaves is much easier over difficult terrain. In hilly areas, this is very much beneficial in comparison to the other transmission media. Microwave systems permits data transmission rate of about 16 gigabits per second. Speed is so much high, 16 gigabits per second speed is there, which other devices rarely gives you this type of bandwidth or this type of speed. Now, some disadvantage also there. It is insecure mode of communication. Anyone can hack it. Anyone can get the information if they put the device in between the two towers. Okay, the signals can be split and propagated in different direction in air and received by the receiver with the reduced strength. It may possible during the windy area, wind time. Okay, the signals can split and communication can be hampered. Microwave propagation is affected by weather condition like rain, thunderstorm, etc. Okay, it affects, weather conditions affects the microwave propagation. The cost of implementing towers and antennas is very high. Okay, however, it uses less cost, but implementing towers and antenna is relatively high. Installation of these things is high. But once installed, there is a maintenance free. These rarely need any maintenance. Okay. Now radio waves is omnidirectional, example of omnidirectional, and microwave is example of directional waves. Okay. See, radio waves uses radio frequencies which are allocated to private businesses for direct voice communication. Voice communication means mobile phones uses this radio waves. A radio setup uses transmitter and receiver. A transmitter sends radio waves. Okay. A transmitter sends radio waves and encodes them into sine waves, which when received by the receiver are decoded. Okay. Encoded and decoded, and the message is received. Okay, some encoding is security is there. In radio waves, data can be secured. Both the transmitter and receiver uses antenna to radiate and fetch radio signals. They are not required in line of sight transmission and hence can penetrate buildings easily. Okay, buildings can be easily. You can see mobile phones are inside our houses, covered with walls, okay, ceilings, so many things are there in between, but we can still receive phone calls, these things, because it uses radio waves. Radio waves do not need line of sight and it propagates in all direction. See the example. This is the tower of radio waves signal, providing radio wave signal, and these signals are receiving. This is the sender. It is sending the information to the tower, and it is the receiver. It is receiving. Okay. From here, signals are transmitting to the tower, and here it is receiving. Like this, anyone can send the data. We having the facility and receive the data. Okay, a radio setup uses transmitter and receiver. Now, some of advantages of radio waves. They can be used indoors and outdoors. There is no bondation, there is no restriction. It can be used indoors and outdoors. They are omnidirectional and can travel in any direction. Okay, propagates in all directions. Transmitter and receiver antenna do not need to be physically aligned. In case of microwave, where alignment is needed, line of sight communication is needed. But in radio waves, there is no need of this physical alignment. Radio waves transmission offers mobility. Mobility means we can move, okay, from one place to another place. There is no restriction there. It is cheaper than laying cables and fibers. Again, it is very much cheaper. Okay, it offers ease of communication over difficult terrain, hilly areas. It is very much fruitful, beneficial for hilly areas also. Disadvantage there, radio wave communication is an insecure mode of communication. However, it can be secured using coding and decoding. Once anyone knows the code, okay, decoding code, then they can tap their data or the communication or the data or the signals. Okay, that's why it is treated as insecure mode of communication. Radio wave propagates is susceptible to weather effects like rain and thunderstorm. It again as microwaves also propagates or affects during rain and thunderstorm. In the same way, radio waves also affects like rain and thunderstorm. Okay, now next one is satellite link. Satellite transmission is also a kind of line of sight transmission, means it is directional unguided media that is used to transmit signals throughout the globe. Satellite is a special type of microwave transmission media. It is a type of microwave transmission media. It provides various types of services such as transmitting fax, voice data, video, email, and other internet related application. In satellite communication, an earth station has a satellite dish which function as an antenna to transmit and receive data from satellites. Okay, earth station is needed for satellite. Okay, now this is the example. This is, you are seeing here, this is the satellite. Okay, and these are the earth station which are receiving the data or sending the data. Okay, satellite is a special type of microwave transmission media. It is same type as microwave, but a special type. Okay, somehow different from microwave communication. Now, so many advantages are there. The area covered is quite large. It can cover up to globe. Okay, not in kilometers or miles, but over the globe, continents, countries can cover using satellite link. No line of sight restrictions such as new natural mountains, tall bending towers, etc. No line of sight restriction. Restriction is not there. But however, it requires line of sight communication. But there is no restriction because no restrictions that a tall building may come in between, a mountain come in between, a tower may come in between. There is no restriction like this. But it is a line of sight communication. Earth station which receives the signal can be at a fixed position, yes, and can be relatively mobile or can mobile. Okay, mobile can be also a fixed position also. There is both can be used in satellite link. Now, disadvantage is there, it is very, very expensive as compared to other transmission media because we have to send satellite, use rockets. Okay, so many advanced technologies needed to fix the satellite space. Okay, installation is extremely complex. Okay, signals sent to the station can be interrupted by external interferences. So many external interferences may be there. Okay, low antenna gains result in overcrowding of available bandwidth. Okay, overcrowding is there. So many satellites are already installed. Okay, installing new satellites is very much riskier nowadays and resulting in low antenna gains. These are the disadvantages. Now next one is infrared. This the type of transmission that uses infrared light to send data is known as infrared transmission. The data is transmitted through air and can propagate in the open space. However, it cannot penetrate walls, okay, walls of the room. It is an example of short-range wireless network. Okay, and infrared speed is vary from 2.0 kbps to 16 mbps. Speed is so much less also. A very good example of infrared transmission is a handheld remote control. Whatever the remote control we use for TV working, okay, those uses this type of infrared communication, okay, such as remote control of a TV, AC, okay, etc. uses infrared communication. What is this? It cannot penetrate walls. It requires line of sight also. Short range wireless network. Speed is so much less, 2.4 kbps to 16 mbps. Okay. These are the things about infrared. See the example here, infrared communication. Okay. This is the transmitter, receiver, and this is the also receiver. Okay, transmitting and receiving can be done from both the end. Housing sealed is there. Okay, these things. This is line of sight is required to transmit data from one place to another place. This is the receiver. This is lens. How many things? This type of transmission uses infrared light to send data. Now advantages are there. It is secure medium of transmitting data. Secure medium is there. It is cheap mode of transmission. Secure in the sense that it transmits data within a range, within a short range, and we can easily secure the system. Okay. Disadvantage of infrared transmitter, it can work only for short distances. It cannot penetrate walls and is affected by distance, noise and heat. Okay. Heat is also there which affects infrared communication. Other unguided media, wireless media, are the two other important media are used, laser waves and Bluetooth. We have not discussed, now we are discussing laser waves and Bluetooth. See, laser wave technology, it is similar to microwave, somehow similar to microwave. How? Just understand here. Laser refers to a transmission medium that requires direct line of sight. As microwave needed line of sight communication, in the same way laser technology also requires line of sight. It provides point to point transmission between points located at short distances. Distance is also short here, such as a building, okay, within building. Similar to microwave, a laser is unidirectional, only one direction, but much faster is there. Lasers requires transmitters and photosensitive receivers for transmission. A disadvantage associated with laser transmission that it is badly affected by weather condition. As microwave affects by weather, wind, thunderstorm, air, rain, in the same way laser technology also affects with the weather. Okay. Now next one is Bluetooth. It is very much common known to us, Bluetooth technology, but what are other merits or other features of Bluetooth technology, just we are going to understand here. Its maximum range distance is 10 meters only. Maximum range is 10 meters only. Bluetooth technology is commonly used in various portable devices such as laptops, PDAs, okay, establish a wire in the form of wireless LAN, Wi-Fi. Wireless LAN means Wi-Fi. Transmission of information using Bluetooth requires a low-cost transmission chip. Okay, it needed very low-cost transceiver chip. Transceiver chip means this chip can transmit data and also can receive data also. Both purpose, for both purpose, single chip can be used in each of the devices that need to be connected. The rate of data transfer in this type of transmitter is 1 Mbps. Maximum speed is, maximum bandwidth speed is 1 Mbps and maximum range is 10 meter only. Very short distance. The connection between the devices can be either point to point or multi-point. Point to point means From there may be one sender, one receiver. Multipoint means there may be one sender and multiple receiver. So this type of like this also. Okay. Bluetooth is equipped with various features such as encryption and verification to provide security. Secure communication is obviously Bluetooth technology is secure communication because it is short range, and encryption feature is there in encryption, verification feature is also there, so it is secure form of transmitting data. Some exercises you have to do: define a network, what are its speed, so many types of questions is there. Now thank you.